Hello kids, let's move on with part 3 of chapter 7, formatting a document. In this part, the first topic is line spacing and how to change it. So first of all, let us understand what is line spacing. Line spacing is the vertical distance between successive lines of the text in a document. We can also increase or decrease the line spacing between a paragraph. So if you want to apply line spacing, follow the following steps. First of all, select the text. Now, click on the line and paragraph spacing button in the paragraph group on the home tab. Now, select the desired option of line spacing from the drop-down list. Or else, to set more precise spacing measurements, click on the paragraph dialog box launcher. As shown in figure, the paragraph dialog box appears. As shown in figure, now select the indents and spacing tab and then select the required line spacing option under the spacing section. Now, click on OK button and observe the changes. See, as you can see that the vertical distance is increased. Now let's understand something. If you want to insert a blank line, press Shift plus Enter key in the bulleted or numbered list that we will see now. Before that, there is one tip over here. Microsoft Word 2010 provides Quick Styles Gallery, which offers a variety of ready-made styles that a user can apply to the selected text. A user can also define the style as per his requirements. Quick styles are available in the Styles group on the Home tab. The default line spacing for most quick style sets is 1.15. So remember, what is the default line spacing? 1.15. Now let us understand how to create list that is bullet or numbers. So lists are of two types, bulleted and numbers. We can format list in a document by using bullets and numbers. Now let's see what is bullet. Bullet is a small graphic symbol that is placed in front of items in a list. To apply bullets to the text, follow these steps. Select the text and click on the drop-down arrow next to the bullets button on the Home tab in the paragraph group. Now select the bullet style of your choice. Suppose square. You will find that the selected text is bulleted and the indents are automatically adjusted to separate the text from the bullets. Similarly, you can apply numbered list to the text. The process is same. Let's know more. To apply numbering effects on the text, click on the numbering button in the paragraph group and select the list style of your choice. Now let's see how to apply border and shading. to improve the appearance and legibility of the text, we can add a variety of border and shading effects to the paragraphs. And the entire page. To do so, select the text. Now, click on the drop-down arrow next to the border button in the paragraph group on the Home tab. After that, select the borders and shading option. The borders and shading dialog box appears. As shown in figure, in that, choose the box option under the settings section. Select the line style under the style list box. So as you can see that there are many options available, the dotted, the dashed. Click on the drop down list of color and select any color. So you can also change the border color. You can also change the thickness of the line from the width section. Click on the drop down list of apply to section and select the paragraph option. Click OK and observe the change. So it is very easy. Now how to apply shading? Click on the shading tab and click on the drop down arrow in the fill section and select a light color. In the Apply To section, click on the drop-down arrow and select the paragraph option. So this way you can apply the shading. Now let's see how to insert clip art. So first of all, what is clip art? Clip art is a gallery of pre-designed pictures that can be inserted directly in a document. To do so, place the cursor where you want to insert a picture. Now, click on the Clip Art button on the Insert tab in the Illustrations group. The Clip Art task pane appears to the right of the document, as shown in figure. Type the desired keyword in the search for text box that is related to the image you want to insert. For example, computer. And then click on the Go button. So as you can see that it will display all the clip art images related to the computer. Likewise, the same way you can search any picture and you can insert it into your document. View the various clip art images using the vertical scroll bar and click on the desired clip art image to insert it in a document. After inserting the image, close the clip art task pane by clicking on the close button. So, it is very easy. So here our chapter 7 ends. Thank you for watching my video.